Today, we're gonna talk about the metaverse.
Intensify the conversation about the metaverse.
You have heard it before, but you are still confused about metaverse. In this video, I will explain you in a very simple way what is metaverse, and in the second part, we'll see how it can be a big career opportunity for all of you. Back in 2007, when I wanted to connect with my brother who lived in India and I was in US, the only option I had was email or a phone call. So you see, the way I connected with him was very primitive, either a text or an audio, and the audio call was very expensive. Fast forward in 2021, the way I connect with people has improved tremendously. Now we have video calls, WhatsApp and Zoom calls, and that too, these calls are free. So the experience is much better. You know, you see a smooth video of that person and you can interact better, but there is a problem with this as well. My experience of connecting with people is restricted to this 2D rectangular box. It could be phone, computer. It's a 2D rectangular box where my experience of connecting with people is being restricted. Imagine a world where I can take my brother out of this 2D screen into this hologram 3D virtual reality, and I can talk with him as if he's present in this 3D space. And it would be even more better if I can touch him. And Metaverse is going to make this possible. Metaverse is basically a next generation of internet and set of technologies that is going to improve our experience of connecting with people and things in general. And it will make it more realistic, more 3D experience. Let me explain how exactly I'm going to take my brother out of this 2D rectangular experience. I bought Quest 2 headset today, which is a VR headset, and it is pretty darn good. When I wear it, I feel like I am in that virtual world and the whole experience is so real. So think about this. I am wearing this Quest headset, my brother is also wearing that, and when we connect in that virtual world, we feel like we are sitting in the same room. It's a very 3D realistic experience that we get. The next milestone will be that if I want to do handshake with my brother, I can wear Meta's Meta gloves. These are in prototype right now, but eventually they will become a reality, and I will be wearing that Meta glove, my brother will also be wearing that, and when I do handshake in the internet, that signal will pass. When you do handshake, you know, you're pressing the points on your hand, that signal will pass, and on the other hand, my brother will feel like he's getting a real handshake. And I can imagine a future where we can wear the jacket, the whole jacket, something like a Meta jacket, where there are sensors all over the places. So if I want to tap my brother on his shoulder, I will do that, and in the internet that signal will pass and the jacket will give that pressure feeling. The way we work remotely is going to be completely revolutionized. Today we connect on work meetings through Zoom calls, but the problem again is that 2D screen, the experience is not rich. Now imagine a metaverse world where you're all wearing these VR glasses and you all feel like you are present in that 3D virtual space. Let's look at this demo real quick.
Imagine if you could be at the office without the commute. You would still have that sense of presence, shared physical space, those chance interactions that make your day all accessible from anywhere. Now imagine that you have your perfect work setup and you can actually do more than you could in your regular work setup. And on top of all that, you can keep wearing your favorite sweatpants.
Looking good. Let's get together real quick for a debrief.
I'm free now. Let's jump in.
Hi.
Hey.
So what do we think?
What's even more better is not only people from IT or computer industry, but people working in factories will be able to work from home. And you'll be like, how is that possible? Well, again, you wear those VR headsets and you can process all the information related to digital factory remotely from your home. And maybe in the factory there are robots who are just operating based on your commands. Do you recall a golden girl from Marvel's movie Guardians of the Galaxy? See, her army there is driving those planes remotely, and it's kind of the same concept. We already discussed some good side of Metaverse, which is many more people will be able to work from home and enjoy flexible lifestyle. As a consequence, the nature will benefit as there are less people on the road, less carbon emission. Businesses will feel more comfortable hiring people remotely, which means if you're living in part of the world where there are less opportunities, do not worry, you will have many more opportunities going forward in this amazing world of Metaverse. But just like with any other technology, with good part comes the bad parts. I can think about three big problems with Metaverse. The first one is social isolation. When I grew up as a kid, we did not have cell phone and we were living in a prison moment. We were more connected with our families, our friends, and the family values were more stronger. In 2021, when I look at kids nowadays, they're hooked onto their cell phone pretty much all the time. They are on Snapchat, any other social media, and they're not aware about the prison moment, which means the family values are diminishing. There is a sense of isolation, and sometimes this results into mental health issues like depression. The second problem will be hypercapitalism. If Metaverse is controlled by few big tech companies, they will know all your spending habits, they will know your behavior, and they will be able to control your lifestyle because they will use targeted ad marketing, they will push a lot of ads at you, and they will kind of hack your social behavior just to make you a consumer of their product. Well, they're talking about Web3 being decentralized, but we'll have to see how that whole thing evolves. Problem number three will be mental health issues. Let's imagine you are a person who is poor, who lives in a very small home, and now in Metaverse you are living in a big mansion. But after living in Metaverse, when you come back to the reality, you know, you will be disappointed because you'll be like, oh, this reality sucks. I better live in virtual reality. Let's say there is a person who cannot walk. Now in the Metaverse, you'll be able to fly and run around. But after spending few hours in Metaverse, when you're back into reality, again, a big disappointment. Let's discuss Metaverse career opportunities now. Back in 2007, when Apple invented iPhone, people were building mostly web applications or desktop applications. There was nothing such as mobile app, and mobile app development started at that point. Similarly, when Metaverse becomes a reality, there will be Metaverse apps, and there will be a huge revolution and so much demand for Metaverse app developers. The kind of developers who can do game programming or 3D programming will have a lot of demand, as every business would want to build their own Metaverse app. Second biggest career opportunity would be for blockchain developers. In the world of Metaverse, people will do transactions using NFTs and virtual currencies. Hence, the programmers who know blockchain programming will benefit a lot, as there will be many more use cases. A lot of software has to be written using blockchain principles. The third big opportunity will be for cybersecurity engineers. As we live in this virtual world and we are more interconnected, there will be concerns about data security, privacy, things like that, and there will be a lot of cyber attacks happening in this world. Hence, people who specialize in cybersecurity, the cybersecurity developer, will have a lot of demands and a lot of cool, interesting problem to solve. The next one is the digital artists, the people who can build digital 3D avatars in the world of Metaverse, people who can build virtual goods or, you know, mansions or cars in the world of Metaverse. All those people will benefit. Maybe you want to go to Metaverse and buy a fancy looking 3D cap or clothes or a fancy car, but these are not real things, these are virtual things, and they might be available up for a sale, and those things will be built by graphics designer or 3D, you know, virtual design experts. Next one will be data scientists, data analysts, and machine learning engineers. As this Metaverse world generates lots of data, especially 3D data, there will be ever-growing demand of applying AI and data science on various use cases and come up with cool solutions. So if you are in a data science space, you will have even more opportunities in the world of Metaverse. And the last one I want to talk about is the opportunities for educational creators like me. People who run YouTube channels today, maybe they will be able to conduct a 3D live virtual class in a Metaverse. And when you attend that, you might feel like as if you are attending a real class. So the content creator, even regular teachers, they will be able to deliver this class, you know, at a remote distance. For example, there is a teacher in India, they will be able to teach a class in USA. But and right now, by the way, you can do that on Zoom, but this will feel more real and people will be more willing to attend such classes. Hence, it increases the career opportunities for teachers and content creators. While I do not like some of the negative consequences associated with Metaverse, I see Metaverse as something inevitable. It is almost like a rising wave. Do you want to fight against it or do you want to learn how to surf it? Let me know your thoughts on Metaverse. What do you think is the career opportunity and threat associated with Metaverse in the comment section below?